Got him pinned on the far boards. Ron flicks it. Aiken, he can't control it. And he'll flick around the far boards. Mahfouz trying to find Blair. Pass cut off. Here's Chad Bennett. Bennett all alone. Pass marks. Goes in and scores. Chad Bennett scores with 18-19 left to go in the first period. Bennett with his fifth goal in the season. He leads the team with five goals now, along with Dane Erickson. And the Wolves lead 1-0 with 18-19 left in the first period. Bad turnover. A pass picked up by Chad Bennett, and he was off to the races, picking up his fifth goal in the season in his sixth game. And the Wolves jump out on top. Just about a minute 41 into our contest. We'll head back towards the bench. Settled down by Seth Ronsberg, trying to find Aiken in the center. Mahfouz on the far side, sails it down for Aiken. Aiken now, far face-off circle, score! August Aiken scores, and we're tied at one. Started off neutral zone, Aiken finding Mahfouz far hand side, redirect to Aiken. He was in the slot and fires it past St. Pierre. And we are not up at one with 16:23 left to go in the first period. Fans, I hope you're sitting down. I hope you're ready for this game. It is going to be a blast here at Hare Arena. And I'm very Ahmed Mahfouz, knocking Mahfouz's stick back towards the far boards as it's Bennett trying to find Judd Warren streaking. And Junior Harris, he picks it up, and Harris, he scores! Junior Harris pumps up his arms. He goes around, takes a puck around a demon, and finds the back door of Mackinsella. Junior Harris with his fourth goal of the season, and Watertown leads again 2-1 with 3:48 left to go in the first period. Some of the fans looking for a call. Some of the fans taking exception to Junior Harris pumping himself up after his fourth goal of the season. Harris with a takeaway. The defenseman couldn't get there in time, and Harris made the Demons pay. The Wolves lead again, 2-1, 3:48 now left in our first period. Inside, pulls a shot, goes high off the glass. And Jared Hicks trying to reach out for it. Meanwhile, here's McDonald, breakaway, pass the defense. McDonald scores! McDonald hits it off Kinsella, and it will take a Watertown roll off the Dayton goalie. McDonald with his fifth, and Watertown leads by 2-3-1 with 2:53 left to go in the first period. He's now got 14 of those points to lead the entire Federal Hockey League. And the Wolves have their biggest lead of the game. With under three to play in the first period, McDonald breakaway. He squeezes his way through Marks and Blair to have an open look at Kinsella. All three Watertown goals have been breakaways, and most of them takeaways for the Wolves. And that's why Watertown has a two-goal lead. A new look for the Wolves, new team for the Watertown, New York area. St. Pierre holds up his left hand and gives up the puck. We're going to have a face-off to the right of St. Pierre. The fans starting to make some noise on the cue of the Demons bench. August Aiken against Lucas Labelle. Labelle wins it. We're going to have a fight. Here is Phil Granger versus Brandon Blair, center ice. Blair shaking his left hand, and Granger goes in, and Blair hits him in the back. Blair, left-handed hooks to the back of the noggin of Granger. And Blair, couple more, and Granger struggling to stand up. Granger now takes the turns, and he puts Blair on one knee. Granger, nice job swinging his partner around, do-si-do, and it is still going on. Granger and Landon Blair tangled up by the linesman, pumping up this Dayton crowd here. Pumping up the bench, pumping up the fans. Blair and Granger will serve five for fighting. Now, if you're a Demons fan, you might start to think this could be the recipe So popping up right now, Coach Karazovic leans on the ice talking to St. Pierre. And one of the linesmen, Mahfouz, keeps it away. Now he's going to talk to Spies. So what you just witnessed was Brandon Blair versus Phil Granger. That ended in a draw. Brandon Blair had a good couple licks on the back of the head of Granger, but Granger held his own. 12:30 left to go in the second period, and things are heating up at this old hockey barn we call Hare Arena. Kravchuk ran Weinsberg up front. Dustin Skinner waits on the far-hand side. Picked up by Kravchuk. Stopped by Van Weinsberg. 6 seconds. Shot by Skinner on the one-timer. And score! Jared Hicks, power play goal! 3-2 Watertown! Jared Hicks, power play goal, the third one for the Demons this season. He finishes Dustin Skinner's shot, hits it off St. Pierre, and Hicks goes back. He does the cleanup duty, and St. Pierre has allowed his second goal in the night. Watertown, however, still leads by a score of 3-2 for Jared Hicks. His fourth goal, he now leads the team in that category. Controls it. 7 minutes left in the second, and Dayton trails by one. Up for Aiken in the neutral zone. Swept back by Judd Warren. Judd Warren passes Junior Harris. Judd Warren controls it towards his right. Shot on Kinsella. Loose puck, and Junior Harris scores his second tonight. Watertown back up by two. Junior Harris, cleanup duty for the Wolves that time. Judd Warren picks up his first assist in a Wolves sweater. Hits off Kinsella. Comes bouncing towards Junior Harris, and he takes the shot and makes it count. Watertown now leads 4-2. Junior Harris with his second, and Junior Harris with his fifth on the season. MacDonald, and Weinsberg looks, trying to find Marks. He'll play it on the back boards. Marks to Fisher, now looking, score! Brian Marks, power play goal! Ryan Marks with a power play goal, looks towards Sean Fisher towards his right, and goes for the shot over the shoulders of Joe St. Pierre, and the Demons are down by one again, 4-3 Watertown. Two power play goals on the night for the Demons from Jared Hicks and Brian Marks. They have scored power play goals number 3 and 4 on the night. 10:52 remains in our third period. Demons trail the Watertown Wolves 4-3. And Brian Marks scores his second goal of the season. An opponent, it looks like it will be Brett Wall. Wall taking the slow spiral into the far faceoff circle. He will clear it away from MacDonald, but it's recovered at the far point. Loose puck off Kinsella and score! 7 seconds in, and Watertown has taken a two-goal lead again as Kinsella flips the cage out of the bolts. And Watertown leads by two again. 9:06 left to go in the third, and they take a grand whopping total of 7 seconds to put themselves up by two. Looked like Kinsella had it, but it trickled down his left-hand side, and that was easy putback for Watertown. We'll see who gets that goal. That's Harris. That's a hat trick for him. Marks to Mahfouz. Mahfouz back to Marks. Marks forehand side. Out of the zone he goes. Marks now. Far corner. Judd Warren trips him up. Loose puck recovered by Mahfouz. Now it's Van Weinsberg. Loose stick. Spooner lost his stick. Here's Mahfouz. He loses the bag. A shot by Van Weinsberg. Score! V12, room! Robert Van Weinsberg pours it in. He gets it from Ahmed Mahfouz, and the Demons trail once more by one, 5-4 Watertown, 7:55 left in the third. Opens it up. Little bit time left for the Demons, but not a lot, but it is 4-on-4, loose puck, here we go! Ronsberg, all alone, shot, score! We're tied at 5! On a botched faceoff by Watertown, the far point, Seth Ronsberg comes through, breakaway, Colby Spooner can't catch up with him, and we are tied up at 5. Still 4-on-4 hockey for next minute 26. We're tied at 5. Have a fourth attacker on for 50 seconds. An abbreviated power play. It's a minute in overtime. Erickson now, he races with it. And this could be it. Brunner, he loses it, slips it, and Erickson scores! Dane Erickson scores the OT winner, and the Watertown Wolves will stay undefeated. And they pick up 2 points out of 3. And Mahfouz going at the back of Lucas LaBelle. LaBelle is smothered by Ahmed Mahfouz. And the Watertown Wolves win 6-5 in OT here at Hare Arena. Right now, Mahfouz just jumped at Lucas LaBelle. And the refs and the linesmen had no time to react. And right now, Blair going out with a Wolf too. Looked like trouble when Bronner had it, but he gets a nice pass. And Erickson scores the OT winner. Mahfouz gets on top of LaBelle. And Mahfouz will be the first one escorted out. That's a final in overtime. The Watertown Wolves 6 and the Dayton Demons 5. And now what do we have? We have Skinner now going at it with another Wolf. You know, folks, I kind of venture a guess that these two teams aren't going to like each other in the few matches we're going to see in Watertown, New York, and Dayton, Ohio. Brandon Blair now shoved out. Right now, the coach is, one of the assistant coaches, talking to the ref. After Dane Erickson scored that OT winner, things just erupted. Who could have seen that ending? The Demons tying it up late in the third, and Watertown has won it 6-5. We'll step aside. We will recap the game for you as you're listening to the Gem City Sports Network and you're watching live on FHL Live. It's a final in OT. Watertown defeats Dayton 6-5. Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen.